The Ford Escape is an entry-level SUV that provides basic SUV capabilities. Speaking of basic, we're going to go back to the basics because if you've seen the styling of some of the newer Escapes, I think it's safe to say that the more conservative lines of the second generation Ford Escape are a little more heartwarming. So, this is the second generation Ford Escape, and this car was produced between 2008 and 2012. Now, what was once a car that was anywhere from $20,000 to $30,000 and it was brand new depending on configuration can now be had for just a few thousand dollars. This is also great, especially if your teenage son or daughter just got their license. The Ford Escape is everything that a new driver needs in a car. Space, practicality, fuel efficiency, front-wheel drive, or even the available all-wheel drive if you live in a climate that has snow. The Ford Escape also has a lot of appeal, and this is evident by the fact that this was one of the top benefiting cars from the Cash for Clunkers program from the late 2000s. Sales of the second generation Ford Escape have increased by just about 50% because of which. And today, we're gonna find out what makes this car so good. So let's talk styling for a second. While the second generation Ford Escape is never going to win any awards for being the most beautiful car in the world, it's not bland and boring, but at the same time, it's not overstyled like a lot of new cars today. The second generation Ford Escape has grabbed styling elements from its bigger brothers, the Ford Expedition and the Ford Explorer, and that is part of the reason why the second generation Ford Escape is beloved by so many new car buyers as well as used car buyers today. Power plant options for the second generation Ford Escape are either a 2.5-liter four-cylinder engine or the 3-liter V6. Now, power outputs for the Ford Escape range from about 170 horsepower to 240 horsepower. Now, again, this either can be had with a front-wheel drive or an all-wheel drive configuration, but what's also pretty cool to know is that this vehicle right here was the first flex-fuel hybrid vehicle to be made. So, pretty cool fact. Now, the Ford Escape achieves 34 miles per gallon in the city and 31 on the highway, which is really not too bad for a 10 to 12-year-old SUV just like this car. Now, another thing you have to remember is that this car came out right at the time when the financial crisis was going on. So when gas prices were $4 a gallon, people were buying these cars like hotcakes because they wanted the practicality of an SUV, but they also wanted fuel efficiency as well. So you get the best of both worlds. Now, if you don't want a hybrid and you just want the gas-powered V6, you're still going to get respectable fuel economy in the mid-20s, which is not great by today's standards, but it's not awful either for a car of this size. Now, I know what you might be thinking, the Ford Escape is just an entry-level SUV, you can't possibly tow anything with that. Well, actually, if you do get the V6, you're going to tow up to about 3,500 pounds, which is really not too bad. So you can tow a small trailer, a small U-Haul, if you got to take your teenage son or daughter to college, or even if you're just doing things around town and you just need to haul some stuff around. So you do get a little bit of towing as well, which is nice for something of this size. Another neat thing about the second generation Ford Escape is that these seats here, the non-leather seats, these are made out of 100% post-industrious material. So what does that mean? It's pretty much 100% recycled material. So pretty environmentally friendly in that aspect too.
The Ford Escape is very safe, and this is highlighted by the fact that this is one of the top-rated vehicles in its segment. On top of that, there's also the MyKey system, which essentially allows you as a parent to control aspects of the vehicle, such as the top speed, how loud the stereo can be, and it also allows you to program additional chimes for when the fuel runs out, which essentially will give your teenage son or daughter more time to stop for fuel so they don't get stranded in the middle of the road. Okay, so what is the Ford Escape like to drive? Well, although it is an entry-level SUV, it still drives like an SUV. Now, one thing about SUVs and crossovers these days is that the engineers at these car companies have done such a good job that they pretty much drive like cars. But I mean, when I drive this thing, it still feels like an old school SUV. Now, of course, it's not a Ford Bronco. It does feel like an Explorer or an Expedition, but of course, just scaled down quite a bit. I'm coming to a stop here, and I don't know if this is because this is a hybrid, or I don't know if it's just one of a design flaw of this car, but the brake pedal feels kind of springy. It kind of feels like I'm stepping on a clutch pedal. I'm driving this car right here, and so far it's not too bad. I mean, it's got electrically assisted power steering, so It essentially aids in handling. It's not uncomfortable to drive, it's not terrible. And if you do get a nicely optioned vehicle, such as one with the limited trim, you get the leather upholstery, you get a navigation system, which, of course, the Escape being a vehicle that you can easily upgrade if you want, you can just pull out that stereo, or even if you don't have navigation, you can just pull it out. Go to crutchfield.com and you can get a nice doubled in head unit and get Apple CarPlay if you want. So overall, what's it like to drive? Not too bad. You know, it's an entry-level SUV, it's a compact SUV, so it's not going to drive like a sedan, but for what it is, it does drive pretty decently. So far, the only complaint I have is with the brake pedal. It feels like I'm stepping on a clutch pedal. Visibility is very good, so in a car like this, you do have quite a fishbowl, so you can see around you pretty well, but of course, the car has a pretty short hood, so you can see right what's in front of you, especially if you're in a tight spot or in a pinch. Now, of course, coupled with that is the good ground clearance. So again, this car is not going to be terrible off-road, or even in you're in a climate where it does snow a lot, especially if you get the all-wheel drive model. Something about the interior here that I want to say is this gear shifter here and some of the plastics, I'm going to be honest, they're not that great. Now, of course, this is a Ford product and it's a more budget vehicle as well, more entry level. So of course, you're not going to get the highest materials used in here as well. But I mean, they haven't really aged too well, especially if you've been in a newer vehicle and then you're stepping into this car, you're going to see that some of these plastics just don't have that nice of a feel to them. This gear shifter, I don't know if it's this car in particular, but when you shift it between gears, between park drive, there is quite a bit of force required to move it back and forth. So again, another little complaint about this car. Not terrible enough that I'd write it off, but just something to keep in mind if you are looking for one of these cars. Now, as you can hear, I'm driving over a pretty bad road, and the Escape does a pretty decent job at absorbing all of those holes. Now, this car has 98,000 miles on it, so the suspension's a little bit tired, sure, but I mean, I'm not bouncing around either where I hate the ride. So of course, continuing the theme of conservative styling, that also applies here in the interior as well. The buttons here in the center stack for the radio are very intuitive, very easy to press, nothing is out of reach. And I've always liked kind of compact vehicles, compact SUVs especially, smaller trucks, smaller SUVs, everything is easily accessible. My stereo is right here. If I had navigation, I can easily access it without having to lean forward. And I do like that. It's very comfortable. It's a very cozy ride. And again, the fact that you get this fishbowl effect makes you seem like you're right on top of where you're going and how you're driving. And it just gives you a confident feeling. Now, this isn't a performance vehicle of any kind, but again, as I'm driving this car here, there is a little bit of numbness in the steering, especially towards the center. You can move the wheel an inch or two and, you know, nothing really happens, but I don't know if that's just a design characteristic of this car or if it's just tired, you know, steering coupler or something just being worn out. And Ford did put some thoughts into the interior as well. For example, you got these cutouts here in the center console. You got this space up here where you can rest your phone or your wallet. You got a little slot here for a pen. You got another place here for some change or some napkins or something like that. The center console is also pretty deep as well. And apparently back in 2008, when this car was new, the center console was large enough to accommodate a laptop at that size. And if you do have a laptop that is pretty small by today's standards, I'm sure you can still fit something in there, like a MacBook or something small like that, a tiny little computer. You could definitely fit a tablet in there, that's for sure. And honestly, I like cars that have large center consoles, especially when, you know, you don't have the most storage or it's not a big car. You do get these cubbies here on the door panels, which is nice, but again, it's not a massive amount of room either, but it's nice that you do have a pretty large center console here with a coin slot, so you can store all your coins easily and not have a mess here in the center. You get trays in the middle that are removable as well, so it's nice thinking on Ford's part that they gave ergonomics of this vehicle great thought as well, which makes driving it just that much more enjoyable. So what would it be like to live with this car every day? So again, it's an entry-level SUV, which I know I've said probably 3 or 4 times by now, but it's not bad. I'm not saying that in a negative context. You know, it goes to show that you don't need to go out and buy an Explorer. You don't need to buy an Expedition or a Chevy Tahoe or anything that's going to be a gas hog in a massive car like that. Now, again, you're never really going to tow anything too massive with this car because it's just one of its limitations. But at the same time, if you do have to make a couple runs to Home Depot or you are carrying, you know, four adults, you can do that comfortably. They're not going to be claustrophobic in here. And you got two cup holders here in the front. You got two in the back, right at the back of the center console. So you do have that practicality as well. And this is great where if you do decide to get this car for your son or daughter, then they can drive their friends around and they're pretty comfortable as well. They're not going to have any complaints either. You know, what's funny is I'm driving around reviewing this car and I'm seeing a lot of Ford Escapes everywhere. Now, the Ford Escape, this is based on the CD2 platform, which has been around since the first generation Escape all the way back to 2001. However, in driving this around and reviewing it, I am seeing a lot of Escapes, second gen Escapes, just like this car, which again is a testament to all of the qualities that this car has and what makes it so attractive and why it's so appealing. Overall, I like this car. I like this SUV. It's not perfect, like I highlighted before, some of the drawbacks of this car, particularly in the interior. But if you do find a nice one, I think this can make a pretty reasonable used car. It's got pretty good ground clearance. It's good in the winter. It's good for carrying stuff. If you gotta do a little bit of home improvement, a little bit of home remodeling, you know, nothing too crazy. It's not bombarded with technology where, you know, over time, those things are just gonna break and you have to replace them and they might be costly, but it's not a bare bones basic car either where you have electric windows and power locks as your only options. Now, the audio system in this car is not that great. At least you have speakers, at least you have something to listen to, we can put it that way, but the audio system struggles the most with the bass, so if you do pick up a Ford Escape, you might want to consider just upgrading the speakers, possibly getting a small subwoofer if you are into audio and you like your music. But look, there goes another Escape right there. So overall, what do I think of the second generation Ford Escape? Overall, I think this car has my win. It's not bad. It's not the best SUV that's ever made, but overall, for what you get here for a few thousand bucks, you pretty much get a pretty reasonable little SUV here. It's not terrible. It's a Ford product, so I'm sure reliability is not gonna be too much of an issue, although if that is one of the things you're concerned of, I'd look for a gas-powered car as opposed to the hybrid, because you are gonna have to replace that battery at some point. And avoid the earlier years, so avoid the 08s, avoid the 09s. From some of my understanding, those cars tend to have issues with the transmission, so if I was in the market, I'd look for a 2010, 11, or a 12. Something to consider if you are looking for one of these cars. But at the end of the day, it's a Ford product. I've seen a ton of these around, you know, even today while I was driving this car for a little bit filming. So overall, I think this car is a pretty major win. So with that, I want to thank you guys very much. I hope you enjoyed this little review here of the second generation Ford Escape. If you've enjoyed this video as much as I did making it, please do head and give it a big thumbs up. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. Go ahead and hit that bell icon to receive notifications, and go ahead and drop a like. That'd be very much appreciated. Follow me on Instagram @GarageDenali. Thank you very much, and take care.